Hello, a very good evening and welcome to the 30th edition of Trends Talks. As you know, we started this during the pandemic to involve people from different walks of life to have a conversation on different ideas. And today we have somebody from Bamboo India who has been involved in sustainable innovation wherein he's trying to substitute plastic with some of his bamboo products. It's a first generation startup which is on a mission to convert this into a poor man's choice of using bamboo. So let me invite Yogesh Shinde, who is the CEO of Bamboo India, is going to talk about some of his products and enlighten us about some of the initiatives that he has taken. So over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir, for this wonderful opportunity for to present us in front of you. Thank you all your audience for supporting such a good cause. So let me begin. I would like to share some slides first. I will go through all slides and we will discuss so that at least everyone knows what we are doing and what we are planning to do. So just give me just a 1 second. Yes. So are you able to see my screen, sir?
Yes, we can see you on the screen.
Are you able to see my screen, sir?
Yes, we can see it.
Hello?
Yeah, we can see your screen. Are you able to hear me?
Hello, yes, sir. Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, I can see your screen.
Anybody from the audience can confirm that? Are you able to see my screen? Hello.
Yes, we can see your screen, sir.
Yes, Yashudas.
Yeah, we can see the screen. Yes, yes. Yes.
Hello. Yes, Mr. Iyer, are you able to see my screen?
Yes, yes, we can.
Hello, I'm not able to understand what to do now.
So we can't hear you. So yes, we are recording this session on YouTube for general viewing purposes. So just a quick disclaimer would be that if you are on camera, you might want to stay off it for privacy. So let me hand it over to Yogesh ji for continuing the session and his presentation. Here,
sure. Yeah, thank you, Krishna Raj. Thank you so much for this wonderful session and wonderful opportunity. So hello everyone, my name is Yogesh. I am representing Bamboo India in this platform. So what is Bamboo India and what we are doing? I will just go through it in just as quick as possible. So before starting any session, I would always like to ask a very generic question. So where is your last toothbrush? The same toothbrush which you are using since your childhood, the plastic one, right? So maybe you changed last week, or maybe yesterday, or today, or maybe last month. So where you throw that bamboo toothbrush, where you use a plastic toothbrush? Maybe you throw in your dustbin, then it will transport to a garbage truck, and then it will be a landfill. So it's the journey for that particular toothbrush is for next 400 years, because any plastic took around more than 400 years to decompose, especially the brush part, plastic toothbrush part. So maybe you must be thinking, why I'm talking this, because this is a motivational speech, or it should be a motivational kind of activity should be happening here. So why I'm asking such kind of a negative thing? Because when I heard about this, and when I search, then I realize in India, we are throwing around 15 to 20 crore of plastic toothbrush every month to the garbage. So can you imagine how much a plastic waste we are generating just using a plastic toothbrush? And this is not happening from today. So it is happening since 1938. And all the toothbrush you are using since your childhood. So whenever you introduce your parent introduce you for this plastic toothbrush or the brushing. So from that day till today, all the plastic toothbrush still exists in this planet and creating a pollution. So the birds are eating, the animals are eating unknowingly, and it's also very dangerous for the environment as well. So what we can do for it, right? So that's what people are talking about, using miswak and neem stick. But in daily brushing habits, it's like a morning ritual. So it is very difficult to use neem or miswak on daily basis, because it will take a lot of time. So what we can do, so this, when this idea struck to me, so we introduce a bamboo toothbrush. Yes, so this is a bamboo toothbrush we introduce in Indian market around 4.5 years back with the name of Bamboo India. And since then, so it is a 100% bamboo. You can see the handle is completely made from bamboo. Maybe you must be thinking, what about the bristles? Because this is the bristles part. But I will just tell you one small thing. The bristles is only a 3% of this entire toothbrush. The 97% of the entire handle is made from bamboo. And this 3% is less than 0.8 gram of nylon. Plus, there are various materials now coming in the market which is compostable. Yes, you are correctly heard. There are lots of companies are researching on various materials. So earlier, these bristles part is only made from the petroleum-based product. But right now, there are various companies like DuPont or the Perlon. They are making these bristles out of vegetable oil. So that is edible oil. So these few products in our catalog, you will find it's a bristles also compostable product. So like this, we started making lots of bamboo products. So the basic intention of Bamboo India is to reduce plastic with bamboo. And we started this journey around 4.5 years back. If you ask me precisely, then 15th August 2016, we started this journey along with my wife, Ashwini. And this in last 4.5 years, we developed lots of products. We have made a bamboo comb, bamboo straws, lots of bamboo products. And now in last 4.5 years, we saved. So whenever we sold any product, we calculate the grammage of that particular product. So how many grams of plastic we have saved so far. So in last 4.5 years, we saved more than 13.5 lakh kilogram of plastic waste. So that is the impact of this small initiative, just change your brush. So very few customers. So right now we crossed more than 50,000 order base in last 4.5 years. And because of those 15,000 orders, we are managed to save successfully more than 13 lakh kilogram of plastic waste. So that is a big achievement for the entire Bamboo India family, all the customers. We sincerely thank all of you to make this happen. And the journey is going on. So, as I told you, we started this company on 15th August 2016. The basic intention to start this company to give an alternative to plastic in terms of bamboo. And why 15th August? Because we got a freedom from on that particular day. Now India need a second freedom from plastic, because you know, you can see the plastic everywhere right now. This current government, the Modi government, successfully imposed ban on single-use plastic, and last 2.5 years you can see there is a huge drive is going on across the city, across the nation. Like, awareness is increasing, and this is our contribution for this movement. Secondly, just tell you about my background. Like, I was a software engineer by profession. I worked around 14 years in various IT companies. I traveled more than 20 countries so far. I work around more than 5 years out of India, Germany, UK, that region. And while traveling, I realized like the condition of that their farmer is much better than us, because of there are lots of things, technology available there. The corporate farming is available there, and there are lots of they always work with their potential. They are work of their the home crop. And similarly, when I came to India, when I started thinking what I can do for our country, I can do for my farmers. That time, we successfully choose bamboo as a raw material, because again, the same question hit my mind. What should I start? Where should I start? Because helping farmers, it is not like giving them 100 rupees or 1,000 rupees and they should start. You can just donate it and forget it. Our responsibility is not ends there. So we need to create empowerment. We can create a job for them. We can create an environment for them. So that is the reason I started interacting with the farmers, I interacting with the experts. And then I came to know about bamboo, because bamboo, India is world's second largest bamboo growing country. And being a second largest bamboo growing country, our export is not that lucrative or not that percentage. We are still in the single digit in terms of global market, global product, bamboo product export. So I thought this is a good opportunity, because we are already at the bottom. So we can't go further down. So there is the only chance we can go up. So that is the reason we started making these bamboo products, alternative to plastic. And we come up with, right now we have around 32 different products in our catalog. Right from the earbuds, the bamboo earbuds, to bamboo comb, bamboo mobile holder, bamboo, as I told you, straws, right? Bamboo tongue cleaner. So there are huge products available. Even my watch also made from bamboo. So I'm using this for since last 4.5 years, and it's working very fantastic. So only I change sale once, but yeah, it's a very beautiful product. So like this, there are lots of products. When we when I discussing with all my friends, even 4.5 years back, when I ask someone what things you can made out of bamboo, so people always say, okay, we can make a ladder, we can make a furniture, we can make a cottage, a scaffolding, toys. But not more than 10 articles we can name if you want to use the bamboo. But when I started reading, then I really found bamboo is a so versatile material to work on. Then why only 10 products? Then when I explored more and more, then I found it's more than 1,800 known bamboo uses available in the market, right from the flooring tiles to the curtains, the bamboo wall panel, bamboo skirtings, bamboo, you can say bamboo fabric, right? So there are lots of things, bamboo jewelry. There are a huge collection of bamboo articles available in the world. But unfortunately, the farmers, those who are growing bamboo, they are not aware what kind of a market demand is for the bamboo products. And I think being an educated person, I traveled a good amount of years so far. So I thought I could be the link between farmers and the market. So that is the reason I came back to India. I studied something and then I started this work. And so far, it's a very wonderful journey. I really like all those supports I'm getting from across the globe. We are starting exporting this product around 18 different countries. Yesterday, at the same time, I had a very good discussion with one of the group in US. They invited me for the session and we had a very beautiful talk. And now they are sincerely thinking they will set up a stall or they will set up a small workshop in US where I can export those products to direct US and it will directly go to the customer. So that channel we are working on. So there are lots of opportunities are in this field, especially in the sustainable field, because next 5 to 10 years or even more than that, people will only talk about sustainability, then the replacing the plastic and the global environment, the way the rain is happening, the way lots of global temperatures is increasing, and lots of things happening is not good for the Mother Earth. So you should not only think about the MRP, that is the maximum retail price, but at the same time, you should think about what is that product cost to the nature. The best example is straw. You use straw only for just 2 minutes, 1 minute or lesser than that. But after that, throwing that straw, it will be there on the earth for next 400 years. Because it's made from the petroleum-based product, it will not dissolve in the soil easily. The birds, the sea animal, they are not aware that this is a plastic, this is not a edible. They will eat and they will die. So there are lots of negative things happening. So why use plastic straws? Go just switch for the paper straw, or you can switch for the reusable bamboo straw. There are lots of other alternatives are available. So before using any kind of plastic product, just have a look. Is there any alternative products available in the market or not? Initially, it will be a costly affair. But again, if you compare with the plastic, then everything looks cheap, right? Everything looks costlier because plastic is so cheap. But the same thing happened with me. We started bamboo toothbrush selling at 180 rupees initially. But gradually the production increases, the response we got, and finally we are selling the same product at only 50 rupees, 50. And that is also in coming days, we are going to reduce the price. And it's my dream to get these products under 25 rupees as a MRP. And very soon we will achieve that target as well, because initially we were find too difficult to sell this around 100 brush per week overall. But right now we are manufacturing more than 50,000 bamboo toothbrush per day in Pune. So I would so it's a great achievement for my entire team, right from my the person who is working on the machine, the person who is doing the marketing, the person who are engaging in all activities. So it's a great support from all the celebrities, the industrialists, the minister like Narendra Modi ji, our Prime Minister, Nitin Gadkari ji, Harshavardhan Goyal ji, everyone. They are very, very helpful in this case. They are promoting sustainability, the bamboo, very, very well. So I'm just requesting all of you, like, at least do visit our website called bambooindia.com, or visit our Facebook page, or all kinds of bamboo products available in the market. This will really boost the morale of those entrepreneurs like me, because your single purchase or single word of appreciation or single like on the Facebook page or social media give us a very, very good feeling like we are doing on the right thing and we are on the right track. So this is what I was about to tell you from this session. Thank you so much for your time. And it's really great to interact with you. So this is all about Bamboo India. You can find all the detail available on the social media. If you are in Pune, if you want to visit our factory, you are most welcome to visit our factory. If you need any kind of help, then all our contact details available on the net. You can get in touch with us. We would definitely help you out, because being a first generation startup, I know what is the pain to start any organization and to reach at particular level. So just like lots of people given me hands, That is the reason I raise myself at this level where I can talk to you. Similar, I would like to give you hand to bring you on the same level which I have today. So thank you so much once again. Thank you, Iyer sir, for this opportunity. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, sir. It was a wonderful presentation. I was trying to show the slides as well so that we can try and compare to what you are talking. And the slides would certainly help our participants who would be watching this on YouTube. So going further, let me quickly ask you a few questions. If you have time, I believe 5 minutes. Okay. So, so you mentioned that you had to come from Europe specifically for starting a setup wherein you can contribute towards sustainable development, reduce plastic and all that. So what triggered you to think of leaving a career like that and coming to India and doing something of this kind?
Sir, actually, when you are out of your own city, you will realize the importance of your city. If you are out of your home, then you will realize the importance of your home. So similarly, when I was out of India, I really found India is very closer to me that time, because that time I can neutrally think how the people thinks about our country, how the other people thinks about our people. So all those things give me lots of contribution. There are lots of remarks going on, the negative remark definitely, which really trigger me off why people are so negative about India. So, and even in the past also, our leader not projected India is a developed country, or they always consider India as a developing country. But I think India is already a developed country. It's a matter of how you see. Okay, the great rich variety, heritage, the variety of all those kind of diversity and the unity that India has, no other nation has. That's for sure. And I thought when it comes to the farmer, so there are lots of discussion happening within our friends in coffee room or the conference room or the work desk. So everyone is talking about government should do that, government should do like this, the policy should be like this and that. But then I realized, rather than talking something, I should go to the ground field. I do some contribution, and then I have an authority to say, the government is not doing like this, or government is not like this. Because at the end of the day, I am the part of government, right? If I voted or not voted for this government, that is a different thing. But right now, being a citizen, I am part of this government, and this is my duty. Only tax paying is not my duty. But whatever things happening my surrounding, if I change the one simple life, that is a contribution for the nation building. So that thoughts trigger me off, and then I came back and I exploring this career.
Absolutely appreciate that, sir. And I'm sure when you started this all, there might have been initial challenges, because this is a very nascent industry. Nobody has really tried to do something of this kind. So what were the initial challenges and how did you overcome all that?
Yeah, actually India is a land of challenges, right? So even the road, crossing the road is a challenge, right? Because you never know, there is no meaning of a zebra crossing on the road. Because after staying so long in Europe, I know the why the zebra crossing is required and why we are not following here. Okay, that is joke apart. But yeah, challenge is always there, right? From the funding or the ideation and the support. But what I feel, if every challenge give you the strength, how to deal it. The similar thing happens with me. I approach lots of banks, lots of financial institutes, but they are not able to understand the magic of bamboo. Okay, because the branch manager is always sitting in the AC room and he claims that he saw the entire world. And he is having his own orthodox mindset. He never comes off out of that mindset. So that was the worry part, because the person who never traveled out of his cabin, how can he judge the person who is having this idea or not, right? I would like to tell you one very funny incident here. There was a company, I will not take a name of that organization, but that organization was helping entrepreneurship. They're helping various those who is having idea, that company is having inspiring them or giving them assistance to become entrepreneurs. So I went there and I met him. They given me one mentor. And when I described my entire idea of bamboo, so he said, no, it is not working. Because there is no success story in bamboo. Then why you are trying this? You try something like lathe machine or VMC or CNC, something like this. Don't go there, bamboo, because there are lots of failure cases. You do something else. So he demotivated me and I came back. And after 3 years, they published one magazine. And on that magazine, the cover page, they published my story. the successful bamboo entrepreneur. So that is the journey. Like, those people are always sitting in the AC room, watching television, watching newspapers. They never gone on the field. Like, what they really think happening in the market. So that is the very thing. As far as challenge, again, back to the point, challenges is concerned. The financial challenge definitely was there. I really appreciate my few friends. They given the money from their pocket without doubting my skill set, doubting my vision. I really appreciate my sister, my parents, my wife. They open-heartedly given me money to start. They said, okay, if you are confident, you start your own. I mortgaged my current residence and I come out of it. So whatever challenges is, if you are very much committed to that, your intention is clear, then I don't think so there is any challenge in this world. And like every day is a challenge, as I said. So if tomorrow my CUN security during the lockdown, he went away to his native place, it was difficult to find the replacement because of the COVID. So that is also a challenge. So every day we are finding something else, but it's a funny, it's a wonderful journey. So it's a wonderful experience altogether.
Right. So I'm sure you're working on some new innovation, new innovative products right now. How do you see this company, Bamboo India, going in the next 5 years, or for that matter, even 10 years, if you're really looking at that kind of a long-term horizon?
Yes, you are correctly said, sir. We are an innovation company. We are doing innovation with the help of bamboo, because I know that bamboo is a huge potential. So I will not do any kind of experiment without bamboo. That is for sure. So even if you met after 10 years, we are talking about the same topic, bamboo. We have a different mindset. When I started this company, I was aiming to reduce 1 lakh kilogram plastic waste in next 2 years, first 2 years, which we achieved. Then we targeted 1 million kilogram plastic waste in next 5 years, but which we achieved that in next 2.5 years, that is 4.5 years, we managed, successfully managed. Now, our next target is to reduce 5 million kilogram plastic waste till 2022 December. So that is our short-term goal. We just want to reduce the plastic waste and make this popular, available in the local market. People start selling, buying this product in their local place, like supermarkets and all those native grocery shop and medical shop. So that is our intention. So reducing plastic waste, that is our challenge. Regarding financial goal, I'm not much worried about that, because just like Three Idiots, they clearly mention ki excellence se piche bhago, kamyabi jhagmar ke pichha karegi. So just like we experienced that so far, and we have very minimal, you can say, the requirements for our living. So we really don't need the posh car or something. We are happy with what we have. So we just want to grow organically as much as possible and try to get more and more people connected to our mission. So that is what we are seeing ourselves. But in definitely next 5 years, we will reach around more than 5 crore people in terms of product reach as well as the awareness, and giving them an alternative for the plastic in terms of bamboo.
So that was fantastic. I hope you reach the target and you are able to see breakthroughs in some new innovation using bamboo, and then in your mission of ensuring that we are saving on littering with plastic. So very good initiative, and I wish you all the best. Just before leaving, I want to ask you, how do you feel about being on this platform of Trends Talks?
Definitely. I would like to congratulate you and your passion, because we are the like-minded people. No matter who is watching or how many people are watching, what we really want to do, we are doing that. That is the same passion you are following. That is why we are together right now. And I wish you all the best for your journey, and all your viewers, all the best. You are doing a fantastic job. Keep it up. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. And thank you for joining us, and you have a good night.
Thank you, sir. Bye.